All right, today we're going to talk about free traffic, why you want it, and how to get it. Okay, everybody loves free traffic because it's free. My favorite part about free traffic is the way in which it converts. See, anytime you're looking to gather free traffic, you know, not paid advertising, you're going after free traffic, chances are that all the methods out there, at least most of the methods out there, are going to capture this traffic when they're in essentially buy mode for your relevant offer. Now what I mean by that is, okay, if you're doing Google AdWords, okay, you're doing a pay-per-click in the search results. Someone types in a search, so they're searching for the best coffee maker, and their, you know, search engine returns results, and the top two or three or four results are ads. Now you can put your advertisement right there and pay every time someone clicks on your ad, and that's when you're hitting people in the buy mode. So that's why it's a powerful ad. They are looking to buy a coffee maker, so present them with your coffee maker. The problem with that is because they're obviously in the buy mode, you know, the cost per click can get really expensive. So the winner here is who can optimize, you know, their conversions the most or the best, okay? Because you gotta play with your margins there. So, you know, it's really super competitive, and generally you need a lot of money to kind of test and retest. The other side of that is Facebook advertising. Now, Facebook advertising is really cheap. You can get a lot of views for really insanely cheap. You can even get clicks for cheap. Now, the problem with that though is you have to sell someone on Facebook, okay? They're, you know, retargeting, I don't want to get into that right now, but if you're running just an ad on Facebook, your first ad, okay, they are not necessarily looking for what you have to offer. So you really, it's more of a sales process. So, you know, while it's great and it works extremely well for in a lot of instances, you know, you're not targeting warm or hot buyers. Free traffic, when you gather free traffic, when you drive free traffic, the ways you drive free traffic to your site or to your store, you're finding them while they're searching, while they're in the buy mode. So it converts. I mean, it converts way better than Facebook traffic, and it's obviously way cheaper than Google AdWords. So what we're going to talk about today specifically, because we've been talking a lot about it lately, is how to drive free traffic to your Shopify store. Okay, this will work for anything. If you have a blog or a website or a business, it doesn't matter. It'll work for everything. It's the same concept. But what we're going to do is we're going to relate this specifically to driving free traffic to your Shopify store. Now, the first place I want to talk about, if you follow the channel, you've probably heard me talk about this before. If you haven't followed the channel yet, what's wrong with you? I'm just kidding. But please, you know, subscribe. I give out great information here. People seem to be pretty pleased overall with the quality of information that I give out here. And of course, as always, you know, as you're watching this video, I always put super helpful links down below for you, kind of related to the topic at hand. So if you're, you know, have a Shopify store, or if you're thinking about starting a Shopify store, or if you have a blog, or for some reason you're online and you need free traffic, you know, go ahead and check out some of the helpful links below, you know, after the video here. But let's get back to the topic at hand here. One of my favorite ways to get free traffic right now is Quora. And, you know, this is my Quora profile. Okay, now, I haven't been on Quora too long. It's been around for a little while, but it's starting to really gain popularity right now. I don't know if exactly, but I've probably been down here less than 6 months, okay? And remember, you know, even though I've been an online marketer for, you know, what, 4.5 years now, it doesn't matter because Quora, I came to it brand new, so I had no competitive advantage over, you know, than you would if you started on Quora today. So once again, what we're looking at here is in less than 6 months, I have over 284,000 views. So this gets a lot of eyeballs to it. And what it is, it's a question and answer site. It's kind of the newer version of the old Yahoo Answers. The great thing about it is you can place links back to your Shopify store or your blog or your YouTube channel or wherever you want to place links, and you won't get penalized. And I'm not just talking about here up in your profile. Okay, you can place a link in every single answer. All right, so the way this works is what you're gonna do is you're gonna search out, you know, questions that have already been asked that are related to your niche, okay, or your store profile or your blog profile or whatever you're trying to drive traffic to. So let's say you have a fashion store on Shopify or a fashion blog. So just type in fashion, okay, in the search profile here, and topic's gonna come up, fashion and style. So let's see there. Just click on whatever topic is most closely related to your actual store. And so let's say we're on men's fashion. Here's where we ended up. So what you're going to do is you're going to just look at this and say, you know, what are questions that are getting a lot of views, okay? And you're going to look for questions that have a lot of upvotes, because that means, you know, people are paying attention, okay? So for instance, if you owned a fashion blog or a fashion, you know, Shopify store or whatever, you can see this question right here has 1.5 or 1500 upvotes. There's 38 comments on it. And then we can just click on this and you can see what's been done here. All right, he's given an answer in detail, and you know, people really appreciate this. So what you would do, okay, is you would go to this, let me see if I can find an example. Well, let me just show you what I did. So here's a question that was asked. I'm 20 with $1,000 and heard about the joys of being a dropshipper. Where do I start? I said, well, remember, dropshipping is a business. And it's very possible to do well, but it's also very possible to fail. Either way, it's going to require work. So what I do is I give it a great answer here, okay? And then I put a link to this YouTube video in there, and it shows this video right inside the answer. Now, this only has 207 views, but let's take a look at another one. Could you make $2,000 a month as a full-time blogger? Was a question. So I answer the question. I give, you know, yes, no, here's what you need to know. I go into detail, I put a video in there, and then I say down here at the bottom, feel free to swing by my YouTube channel. I try to be as helpful as possible with regards to many different topics, and there's a link. Now that's 508 views right there. Let's find more. How can I start a dropshipping business with no money? There's a way to do this. You have to have a bank account and a credit card, but you literally need $0. And then here's a link to this YouTube video. And then I talk about it. Give what you need to know. And if you want to know more, you can go to my blog post. That's got 1,400 views. And you can see all this stuff, you know, starts to add up. You know, a little bit at a time, a little bit at a time. But that's the cool thing about it. You can put these links right in the bottom there and you won't get penalized. As long as you're giving an insightful answer. And that's the other thing. You have to give an insightful answer, because, you know, if you don't give an insightful answer and a detailed answer, it's never going to show up and it's going to get zero views. So, you know, put some time into it. So this says, how can I make $5,000 per month working from home? So let's see here. It's always good to put a little image here with a little, you know, title tag in there, because it draws people's attention, helps get that bumped up to the top there. And then so I, you know, I give them an answer. What's the easiest way to make $5,000 a month? You know, I put a link to this video, and this has 27,000 views. Now, if you go to my YouTube channel right now, you know, depends on when you watch this, but at this time, this video has over 20,000 views. And a lot of that is because I seeded it with Quora answers, all right? And that's, I mean, and then after, you know, it starts getting momentum, you know, just kind of takes off on its own, as long as it's, you know, a good video, which that is, or a good blog post, which, you know, is what it's all about. So you can see how this works. I mean, you can just go and search any topic and find answers. And you can kind of even go outside the box. You know, I live in Dallas, so I answer Dallas questions. And just kind of build up your profile. And, you know, that's what it's all about. If you're looking for free traffic, you just got to get yourself out there, you know, as many ways as possible, you know. And then the other thing you can do is, if you want to talk about, easily find what are the hot topics on Quora. Say you're looking for women's fashion. Is your blog or your store women's fashion? And if you just type in women's fashion Quora, okay, and hit enter, you know, chances are the top results that come back in the search results are going to be the ones that are getting the most attention. So for instance, if you click on the second one, women's fashion and style. This question is, women's fashion and style, what are the five essentials for your wardrobe? So if you own a fashion blog or a fashion Shopify store, you're going to know the answer to this. Go ahead and take some time, write a detailed post, and say, you know, if you want to know more about, a great thing to do here would be, see five more essentials. That's it, the content upgrade. That's always great when you're doing stuff like this, content upgrade. Interested in five more essentials for your fashion wardrobe? Okay, click on the link below and send them to your blog post about the 10 essentials or five essentials for your wardrobe. And look at this, has 10,000 views on it. So that's driving a ton of traffic. And the cool thing about this is there's no such thing as duplicate penalty anymore. I mean, yeah, maybe there is, but there's not. Don't even worry about it. So if you have a blog post that's, you know, 1,200 words already, and if you have a Shopify store, you should be blogging, especially if you want free traffic, then you could just take little snippets out of here and simply copy and paste them into the appropriate answer. So, you know, hopefully we've seen some light bulbs there. You know, I don't really want to overtalk that to death. Let's move on to the next source of free traffic, and that's going to be YouTube. YouTube is unbelievable for getting traffic, okay? Because, you know, it takes a little bit of time to make a video, but it doesn't have to be professional, okay? You can just, if you have an iPhone or a Samsung, probably anything, you know, in the past 3 or 4 years, it's good enough to do YouTube. Okay, now if you really want to you know, increase your YouTube game, get like a $10 or $20 little microphone that pins onto your shirt there. You can plug it right into your iPhone and get a little softbox light, or, you know, one of those ring lights or something like that, and a tripod. So for under $100, you know, as long as you have the phone already, I mean, you can start doing good enough quality video to really set yourself apart on YouTube. But, you know, the thing is see what's popular right now. So I've seen this all over the place, these hauls, they call them. And what it is, these bloggers, they go to the store or whatever, and they buy like, you know, $1,000 worth of stuff, and then they simply just show it, I guess. I don't really know. I try not to get too caught up in watching too much stuff on YouTube because, you know, as you know, if you online a lot, you can kind of get lost here from time to time. But what I'm saying is, you know, I've seen these, and I checked them out a little bit. So if you own a Shopify store with clothing or accessories or really anything. I mean, it worked for hunting gear. It will work for athletic apparel, just anything. I mean, anything you sell, really, you can do a reverse haul. And I haven't really seen much of these, so it's probably a pretty good idea that would probably get a lot of attention. So instead of, you know, these people showing what they went and bought, show what was just added to your store. Okay, and then the key here is you got to include the word haul into your title. But you know, title it a reverse haul, you know, your boutique reverse haul, and it'll get attention. I mean, it'll pique people's interest, and you might even start a trend. I'm not gonna do it. Take that. That's a free one for you. And like I said, it won't work for anything. It doesn't have to be clothing. It can be anything. YouTube is great. If you're not making video yet, you know, make some video. As a matter of fact, while I'm thinking about it, I'll put some links in the description below just to kind of show you some of the cheaper but good equipment purchase that you need to, you know, get high quality videos without spending a lot of money. And once again, as long as you already have the iPhone or the Samsung or whatever. So yeah, YouTube, if you're not making video, get out there, start making video. It'll pay huge dividends. The other one is Tumblr. And there's probably going to be people who are going to laugh, but I mean, I've driven a absolute ton of traffic with Tumblr. I mean, it's crazy. I don't know why nobody's talking about this. Probably because they're hoarding it from themselves. But, you know, if you have a niche blog or a niche store, which most people do, then make a Tumblr page that is, you know, related to whatever it is that you do. Okay, so for instance, I just typed in survival gear, and, you know, look at this guy's probably selling paracord bracelets over here. Check this out. Yeah, so this survival kit bracelets is the name of his Tumblr site. And, you know, all he does is just, you know, do pictures of, you know, survival stuff. It doesn't even have to be, you know, stuff you create. You can just reblog stuff. And then all he does is, let's see. All right, so if you want to buy this, watch. Let's see where this sends us. I haven't even looked at this yet. Okay, so it sends over to his Instagram. Let's see. There you go. You click on his Instagram. And then you click over on his Instagram profile. And there we are. We're at his store. All right, this is probably a Shopify store.